Okay, well, thank you for coming out to our little gallery exhibition performance meditation House of Horrors. We're glad you're here. We're going to work with the material of a very, very amazing artist, and thank you, Wyatt, I'm ready now. A very amazing artist, a very amazing Kara Walker. And we're concerned this evening, especially, yeah, Wyatt, that, thank you so much, there we go, now you can really see, that's important. We're concerned with her series, Harper's Pictorial History of the Civil War Annotated. So that's the subject of our extravaganza together this evening. Let's see, I made this PowerPoint. Let's see if it's going to work. Oh, yeah, there she is. So here's Kara Walker. Some of you said you weren't sure who she was. She's a really astonishingly important and influential and accomplished visual artist. And we see in the background some of the figures that she's created for one of her works. Kara Walker has been working. Here's some information about her, so you'll know a little bit about what it is that we're doing together tonight. She's been working for over two decades, and as the PowerPoint says, has been making work that weaves together imagery from the antebellum South, that would be here, but not antebellum, but the South part here. The brutality of slavery and racist stereotypes. She's best known for her use of the cut paper silhouette. She transforms the genteel 18th century portrait medium into stark, haunting tableau. Walker plays with the idea of misrepresenting misrepresentations, stating, the whole gamut of images of black people, whether by black people or not, are free reign in my mind. Her work is near controversy for its use of exaggerated caricatures that reflect existing racial and gender stereotypes, and for its lurid depictions of history, challenging viewers to consider Americans' origin of racial inequality. So this is a visual artist who is working now, who has a lot to help us understand, who has a lot to say, who would not go to Starbucks or Waffle House. In Walker's art, the present is defined by the past, and the past exerts a savage power. Best known for her use of cut paper silhouette. Oh, I saw that part before. That was a problem with cut and paste. I'm sorry. And this came with PowerPoint. Let's skip that. Okay. So here is an example of Kara Walker's work. So what we see are these black silhouettes that engulf our line of sight, that take the presence of our vision, that demand our attention. And as we look at them, we notice that they're quite unusual. They're animals who are people who are dismembered. They are children or sprites who are in flight. They are people being pooped on by chickens or turkeys. They are people devouring each other. They are quite mysterious, provocative. Walker reaches into the psychology of the places we dare not go, but do all the time. Places like Starbucks and Waffle House for black people. Places where history tells us present and future possibilities, or the lack of possibilities. Places where the past becomes the present and the impossibility of being in the line of sight, of being in front, of being in presence. Where there are maybe murders happening behind miscegenated babies. There's always a child nursing. There's always a child nursing. There's always a black woman who is caring for all of us. Walker's maybe most famous piece, in a way, was the sugar spins that she made as part of the Domino Warehouse show just a few years ago. And here we see her in front of the sugar spins itself. She constructed this sculpture out of boards and boards and boundaries and boundaries and carloads and carloads and just huge amounts of sugar. So the Sphinx, as it sat in the exhibit in the Brooklyn warehouse, which was about to be turned into condominiums as the area was gentrified,
the sugar swelter and melted off of the forms as the witnesses and audiences came to take part of seeing this invention that she had made. And yes, many people did lick the Sphinx. Walker most recently created a Calliope of Horrors for the New Orleans Triennial. This work was just shown over last month. There was quite a controversy with the piece itself and the curators for the show. There were questions about authorship, ownership, placement, and as always, questions about black presence, black people in the line of sight, black people in the history of our shared present. The Calliope was quite unusual in its composition. Hopefully it'll still be there the next time any of us are able to go to New Orleans. Walker's work tends towards the erotic, tends towards the fantastical, tends towards the graphic. In this piece, which is part of the Black Atlantic series, we are allowed to witness a white man sitting atop a black figure as he's being serviced by a black woman, while the cupids in the air are indeed nigging out. But on to our subject for tonight, Harper's Pictorial History of the Civil War Annotated. This work is 15 prints. It's based on the two-volume anthology published in 1866, and Walker selected illustrations from this book and overlaid them with large stenciled figures. So we've already seen a bit of how her stenciled figures look, and this is what she's done in this particular series that we're concerned with tonight. So, the Harper's Pictorial History of the Civil War, or in the original version, it's called The Great Rebellion, is really the information that was available to people to understand what was happening during the war to uphold slavery. As people needed to understand what was happening in the field and where it was happening, we could turn, at that time, to Harper's for maps and for these really divine illustrations of the machinery and the objects that were being deployed in this war, the things that were happening in the field with these illustrations that were made by artists who actually were in the field. As reporters go today, they would go to the field and draw as quickly as they could, as much as they could, to help readers in other parts of the country understand what was happening, and created these amazing mythos and amazing representations of the great white men who were fighting not the war of brother against brother, but the war to uphold slavery. The book is filled, the Harper's Pictorial is filled with pastoral imagery so that we can understand how the land looked and maybe how it even felt before the war was happening and as the militias and the armies were being mobilized and moving towards each other, and that we could understand what the machinery looked like as we were waging this war to uphold slavery. And Walker then brings her silhouettes onto these illustrations. She places the black figures at the center of these images that she creates, offers us mutilated and maimed bodies, bodies torn asunder, bodies possibly created in black joy grief, but always somehow related to a certain stereotypical buffoonery. She places the images atop these pastoral landscapes as she's defining ways to rethink this war to uphold slavery. She's thinking about how to force the black people into the front of the way that we might remember the war to uphold slavery, how to force us to think about the presence of, say, black women inside of this war to uphold slavery. Oh, here we see the actual images that Walker's created in their natural habitat, which would be in our gallery, our museum. And what you'll notice is they're quite large, they're huge. And so when all 15 of them are laid out side by side, we really have a sense of immensity in terms of the scale of these images she's created and the forcing of the presence of black people into these narratives of history that help us understand the war to uphold slavery. What we're doing tonight is we're animating these images. We are wondering what happens when the images are alive, when the stereotypes move and they have breath. We wonder what happens when we work through different kinds of electronic wizardry, if you will, to rethink what happens as we force the idea of black presence in front of these images. So join me in thinking through how Kara Walker's work allows us to center black women, especially, in our thinking of the war to uphold slavery. Kara Walker's Harper's Pictorial History of the Civil War Annotated, and tonight we offer Kara Walker Reverse Gesture Review. Let's begin. Thank you.
Thank you. My God, that is strange. That is so strange. It's so erotic and so playful and so, my God, the things they do. And this Kara Walker, and we see her, it's like she's putting heads in front of heads and revealing history inside of history. We have to look through the black head to see the white head, to see the black head, to see the my God. I don't know. Okay, well, this is a little stretch, a little like intermission stretch. It's time to stand up. Just take a little stretch, shake it off for a minute. No, come on, you can do it. Come on, get it. Thank you. Just stand up, a little stretch. Thank you very much. Yeah, just a stretch, what you're taking in, how you're, my God! It's like they want black people at the center of history. My God! Okay, that's better. Yes, let it out, Xavier. Thank you. I'm very glad you're here. Welcome to you. My God! All right, we have a little more to share with you. There's just a little bit more, a few more ideas. We're still thinking about how she's finding this way to present history. My God, this history. All right, well, here we go. We can start up again. Okay, have a seat.
Thank you. full of the hope that the present has brought us, facing the rising sun of our new day. Be good, march on
till victory
is won. Stony the road we trod
into the
chase.
Histories do not render us our humanity. We have so much to do.